shoot people, is there? My dad says outside is shoot people.
Yeah, only if they piss me off. Yeah, you better run. Son, I'll play. Guys, what's up? Welcome back to Let's Play Fallout 4. I'm Dude Long Couch. Alright, so we're back in Diamond City, guys. I did go ahead and install some mods, like I said. Check it out. First one to show you is improved maps on the Pip-Boy. You can see roads and water, and everything's just like configured a little better. It's a little bit nicer. Stuff like that. I also got one that is supposed to improve the quality of the stars in the sky. I didn't notice them before. This is supposed to be like a 4K texture resolution instead of the old texture, which was 1K. Probably. It's a pretty popular mod. I figured I'd grab it. The other one that I got that's kind of a big deal is... So, you guys know I fucking hate encumbrance, and it was really driving me insane. But I found out that there are actually perks that you can get that obviously you can increase the amount that you can carry. You can like raise your strength and you can raise the amount of stuff you can carry through perks. And apparently the last one makes it so that you can still run when you are over encumbered. I guess the only difference is you can't fast travel, but you can still move at a regular pace. Which I think is actually pretty cool that they included that in there, and I think it's the first time that they've done something like that in a Bethesda game. I could be wrong. I know in older games, you definitely, if you were over-encumbered, you were just fucked. That was the end of it. But they included some workarounds in this game. So instead of just turning off encumbrance altogether, I went ahead and compromised, and I got a mod that makes all my junk weigh zero. Everything else weighs exactly the same, all your aid and weapons and apparel, but the junk just doesn't cost you anything. Or at least it's not supposed to. It looks like some of this stuff here still weighs stuff, which is weird, but most of this is at zero, and that actually brought me down to a level where I could run again. I think that's a good compromise for now, because honestly, I hate leaving junk behind. I want to go crazy with the crafting stuff and the settlement stuff, and I don't want to leave junk behind. So like armor and weapons and all that will be a bit more careful about, but junk, I want to be able to just grab everything I find. So that's how we're going to roll for now. Now, I wanted to come back to home plate and check out my house that I bought because I haven't seen it yet, and I wanted to show you guys. I have a lot of crap I have to take care of here in Diamond City, but first I just figured we'd come in here and see what we got. So, this is our house. We have a coffee cup sitting on this thing that comes pre-installed. Nick is walking into the wall. I don't know what he's doing. Alright, we have a workshop here. Now, while I'm here, I should just transfer. Wow, look at this. So I've got some junk already in here. That's pretty cool. I'm going to transfer all the junk I'm currently holding on to. Take all.
Building a collection or something?
Wait, hold up. I don't want to... What is happening? Get out of that. So I took everything in there. I wanted to do that. That's what I was trying to do. Okay, so all my junk has been deposited into this workshop. I don't have to worry about it. Oh, yeah, I also got a better sorting mod so that what it did was add tags onto everything in my inventory so that when I choose to sort, I have much better sorting options. So it just kind of categorizes everything in here, which I think is a really cool idea. I didn't want to go, like, super-duper crazy with the mods just yet because, you know, they're not, like, officially supported, and since they're user-made, you always run a chance of just breaking everything. So, I didn't want to get super into, like, the texture mods and graphics overhauls and, like, adding in, you know, new weapons and items. Wow, look at all this stuff just hanging out in here. It's pretty badass. We've got brooms, we've got ammo and things like that. More healing. Sweet. Food and food rad. Okay, so it distinguishes between regular food and irradiated food. I like that. We've got another exit there. The oven mitt. Alright, so we can add things into here. Let's see, what kind of cool stuff can we build with what we've got right now? I want to look at decorations. Miscellaneous. I've heard that we can build like a magazine rack. And a bobblehead rack. And even though those are two things that are, like, not super helpful gameplay-wise, they're two things that I very much desire. Of course, the problem here is I don't see them under miscellaneous. Would they be under something else? Floor coverings. No, these are all mats and stuff like that. Furniture. It's probably under furniture. Shelves. We've got bookcases. Here we go. Magazine rack. Okay, so we've got like a wall rack kind of thing and a spinner rack. I mean, I'm a pretty classy guy, so I want the spinner rack. And it takes... We only have two screws, apparently, and this takes one of them, but... Building an entire magazine rack with one screw? That's pretty impressive. So... We'll just plop that down right there for now. Now, what about a bobblehead rack? Wall shelf. There's all different kinds of shelves and shit. This is crazy. Maybe when I read that, they were just talking about, like, a bookcase. Maybe there's not a specific bobblehead rack. I don't know. But now that we have that here... Okay. Miscellaneous notes. What would that stuff be under? Mags. Okay, so we'll store it in here. And does it show up? Oh, that's fucking cool. Oh, man, I really like that. I can't wait to just find more of those and fill that shit up. That's really awesome. All right, let's take a look upstairs. We've got a greaser jacket and jeans. Cool. So I've got a dresser. I can store all the extra clothes that I'm not going to wear. And I will totally do that. I just got to go through and see what I have and figure out what I'm going to wear and what I'm going to store in here. There's some stuff I'll probably keep on me, like the stuff that raises my charisma, because if I'm going to be talking to people, I know that I can just throw on the charisma stuff and have a better chance at doing persuasions. Don't even look at this. We got a little patio chair and a grill up on the roof. This is a good buy, guys. Oh, shit, I fell. Alright. Well, that's good. At least I got to see it. I know it's in there for now. We've got so many spaces that we can just build and create things and... just go crazy. Our imagination is our only limit.
Hey there, mister.
All right. So, while we're here,
hey,
we were going to go talk to Piper about something or other. Since we're right here, I guess we'll just do that now. What's up, Pipes?
Nikki Valentine walks into my office for a change.
What can I say, Piper? You, me, and hard luck all seem to run together like acid rain down an old sewer.
You, including your client here in that analogy? So, you two are finally letting me in on this little case of yours. What's the story?
And the last mod that I installed is the actual dialogue mod, so I can see what I would actually say when I choose these options. Because I really like that. Let's see. It takes a little longer to read through them, though. I'm going to find the Institute and make them regret what they've done.
Hello?
Kellogg kidnapped my son. Handed him over to the Institute. I'm going to find them. And make them regret what they've done to me.
The Institute. Oh, boy. I've been investigating these creeps for over a year now. The Commonwealth's boogeyman. Feared and hated by everyone.
True enough.
Sometimes they snatch people in the middle of the night, and sometimes they leave old synths behind to remind us that they're out there. But to this day, there's one thing nobody really knows.
Where the Institute actually is, or how to get in.
Exactly. But there's one person who has to know, right? The guy who just handed them Sean.
Kellogg. Huh.
Too bad he's dead, because I murdered the shit out of him. Hmm. He had to have a way in and out.
You read my mind. He had to have a way in and out.
Yeah, but we both know he's not exactly available for a chat and coffee.
Hmm. Feel like holding a seance? Because he's in hell, where he belongs. I don't know. I mean, that's a pretty badass line, but that might piss off Piper. Let's try it anyway.
Because he's in hell, where he belongs.
So, a murderer and a kidnapper gets his brains blown out by an avenging parent. Huh. Be a great ending if we didn't still have the biggest mystery in the Commonwealth to solve.
Yeah, good point. Look at what I've done. Oh, I'm a monster. None of these options paint me in the best light. Let's just say, so what now?
So what now?
Gets his brains blown out. Huh. His brains. You know, we may not need the man at all.
You're talking crazy here, Nick. Got a fault in the old subroutines?
Look, there's a place in Good Neighbor called the Memory Den. Relive the past moments in your mind as clear as the day they happened. If anyone could get a dead brain to sing, it'll be Dr. Amari, the mind behind the memories.
Who the hell is Dr. Amari?
Who's this Dr. Amari?
I'll let her give you her life story in person. Let's stay focused. I guess we're gonna need a piece of Kellogg's brain. Enough gray matter to bring to Amari and find out if this is going to work.
Jesus, Nick! Gross! Seriously?
I know it's grisly, but what choice do we have? We got no leads, nothing. That old Merc's brain just might have all the secrets we need to know.
Hey man, I'm on board. I'm gonna need a really sharp ice cream scoop. Ugh. I think I have something. Kellogg had this thing attached to his head. I must have picked up something.
Actually, I think I already have something. Kellogg had this thing attached to his head.
Cybernetics, huh? We may have just won the lottery.
Whether we're riding this crazy brain train or not, we can't all go running across the Commonwealth, so who's coming with you?
I have to go to the Memory Den either way, if I'm going to introduce you to Amari. But if you want to head there together, just say so.
Well, if you're going to be going there anyway, maybe I'll bring Piper. That way I have both you there. Yeah, I think that's probably a good plan.
I'll head out with Piper. We'll meet you there, Nick.
Sounds good. You two stay out of trouble. Don't worry. We're going to get your boy back. Just a few more steps.
All right, I'll take your word for it. That reminds me, we also picked up a perk that I never spent. So, let's go in and take a look at that. So, we've got a lot of things to choose from. I honestly am not 100% sure which direction I want to go right now. I'd like to do a little bit more damage in combat. Could also start going down the sneak tree. Oh no. Or we could be able to do more gun mods. We can't do that yet because that requires level 13. Actually, you know what? Oh man. More rifle damage would be awesome. And then this would be maxed out. But the other thing that I really wanted to do was to keep going up the pickpocket. Or not the pickpocket. The locksmith tree. Just because I know that I want to get that maxed out like as soon as possible. It sucks having to leave locks behind just because you're not high enough level to try them. I just don't know, guys. I just don't know. I think we'll do this for now. It'll just give me access to, like, more things, more XP from unlocking things, and then I think Rifleman will be the one that we'll go with next. There's still two more levels after this. Master, and then... Oh, the last one is that your bobby pins never break. That's not super important. We can't get Master Locks until level 18 anyway, but we've got as high as we can get for now. So that's good, at least. Okay, so at this point, guys, is Piper coming with me? Yeah, there she is. I am actually going to... What am I going to do? I think we're actually... I should have taken that junk and kept it on me that I deposited in my house. I'm going to go grab that stuff back. I'm going to take all my stuff and I'm going to go back to Sanctuary and start building some things there and start seeing if we can get that settlement going. So I will see you guys there.
Hey.
Shoot.
Hey, Piper.
You know, the Institute has a lot of enemies. The Minutemen tangled with them once. The Railroad still does. I've even got some notes on these new guys. The Brotherhood of Steel.
You said something about the Railroad.
Supposedly, they help runaway synths escape the Institute, but they're secretive. Ultra paranoid. The only thing I have is a rumor. A code phrase. Follow the Freedom Trail.
Interesting.
That Brotherhood airship is hard to miss.
Yeah, the Brotherhood of Steel doesn't do subtle. From what I've heard, they take whatever they want. Especially if it's high tech. They just might have the muscle to give the Institute a run for their money, but they're... Let's just say they have their own agenda.
Tell me about the Minutemen.
You know that group you rescued and conquered? Far as I know, they're the last Minutemen left in the Commonwealth. They used to be a volunteer army, dedicated to protecting friends, family, and neighbors. Sounds soft, but they were a real thing at one point.
We should get going.
All right.
I wanted to see if she would say anything about me standing here in nothing but my tidy whities and a gas mask, but she didn't care. I actually took off the armor I had because I found out that not only does it weigh a ton, but the stuff that I got from Kellogg is actually way the fuck better. Well, not way better, but better. And it weighs a lot less. So, this is what I'm gonna wear for the time being. Okay, now I will actually cut to Sanctuary, like I said before. So I left this radio antenna here. Recruitment radio beacon.
This won't work without power.
I never did figure out how to supply the damn power to it, though. Generator runs all the time. Doesn't really do me any good.
You're tied to this place, kid. Your energy.
Oh god, I forgot about you.
I used to live here. A long time ago.
Ah, but the distant past ain't so distant for you. I saw you leave that icebox. This whole world is like some bad dream you can't wake up from, isn't it? The sight can help you, kid. It always has answers. Just gotta bring me some jet so I can see what it wants to tell you.
Alright, I think I have some, so let's see what it does.
Here, already have some.
Like a little kick yourself, huh? This'll do. Now, let me ride the high to where the sight wants to take me. You're walking into a sea, but it's not water you're afraid of drowning in. It's something... invisible, but radiant. It burns everything in it. But no, I can feel them. There's people calling out to something, chanting. They can show you the way, but they're so hard to read. Be careful around them, kid. Phew. Wow, that took more out of me than usual. I'm gonna need to rest now, kid.
Well, that was 100% unhelpful, and also it pissed off Piper. So, fuck you, fuck your drugs. I don't think I'm ever gonna do that again. Unless I find out, like, a really good reason for it. Now, I'm glad to see that my power armor is right here where I left it. Can't remember how many, or how much juice this thing had left in it. Let's just take a look. Oh man, I've got 7 power, what were they called, fusion cores? Yeah, like 7.5, that's fucking awesome. Alright, let me out. Actually, this is one thing that I wanted to screw with. So there's a rack right here. I don't know if I can, like, make improvements to this. Transfer. So what do I do? Workshop. Whoa, did I put this stuff in here before? I don't remember doing that. Or is stuff amongst your workshop, like, automatically shared? So if I transfer this into the rack... That wouldn't work, would it? Okay, I'm starting to figure this out a little bit, guys. So... I had to take... I guess there's, like, power armor frames and then actual components. I took the components off of the frame. And now I can come in here and repair them. Let's see, this is at... The helmet's at 25 out of 50 health, so if I hit repair... That costs steel. Okay, well that's... Pretty plentiful, so... Wow, that's a 2 of 50 and it still requires 4 steel. Yeah, we'll do it. I want this stuff ready to roll. And we can also modify them from in here. Whoa, okay. Let's start at the top. No material mod. Damn, this stuff is like... This is complicated. There's a lot of stuff you can do. We can change the military paint. Wait. Increases charisma or increases strength? What the fuck? So you paint it and it changes the stats of it. That's so weird. Winterized coating increases energy resistance. You probably just want to do like strength, right? This takes a lot of stuff. I guess we'll do it. I don't know if this is a good thing to do or not, but shit. Model A, no material mod. No, I don't even know the difference between all these. This is insane. Okay, so that's standard. Could increase the charisma. Is that something I really care about in power armor, though? I think I'd be much better off doing like this. If I had some aluminum, I could increase the armor health. And no misc mod. Well, there's not a ton I can do to this stuff right now. Just need to find more stuff. This I could do if I had the perk, but I don't. Yeah, I don't really see a point to increasing the charisma on this stuff. I don't know. If I'm way off base, I'm sure somebody will let me know in the comments. Alright, so... Now we just transfer all this stuff over, right? And now it's there for the taking, and I can get back in and use it. Okay. Slightly convoluted system, but at least I've mostly figured it out. And I know that it's pretty much safe here. Because I left it for a long time.
Got a favor to ask you, kid. I know it's silly, but I need a chair. Something with a nicer fit for these old bones. Can you do that for me?
I kind of hate you, but I want my community to flourish, so... yeah.
Sure. Be glad to help.
Thank you.
Nice day. Where are we headed?
I actually got a quest for that. You didn't like that when I did something nice for the old, drugged-out crazy lady? Fuck you, Piper. Alright, let's see. So they want more beds. Happiness is at 52%, which is up, but we need more beds and more food. Alright, well let's start with something easy. We'll build a damn chair. Chairs. Airplane seats. Here we go, one chair. It's gonna take all my leather. Well, how about one of these? I don't really see a difference between... oh, this is, I guess it makes six of them every time you do one, though. So they all have different requirements. Okay, well, let's... this one does 12, really. And it only takes two cloth. That seems like a good... thing. I can't do it. Why can't I do it? Oh, it's probably because I'm standing right next to the bench. Okay. Drop that right there. No, it doesn't make 12, you moron. So that's how many I can make with my current level of junk. Okay. So now that I've put that there, I'm gonna figure out how to move it.
I should have done more. I hope those raiders pay for what they've done.
Bro, that's not for you. That's for... I mean, I guess you... okay. I gotta figure you can move stuff around after you've done it. Can I move this guy? Get away. Go over there. Get out of my face, asshole. Okay. If we hold down A, we can pick it up. I knew there was a way to do this. I don't know where Mama Murphy lives. There's a fucking chair right here, you piece of shit. You could have just used that. Whoa, what the fuck? Alright, so I tried to set it down right here, and now my game seems to have glitched. I am completely stuck here. This is great.
Looking forward to that chair. You're so kind, helping me like this.
Yeah, I'm trying to set it down. Game's being a real knob about it, though. Store chair in the workshop? No. I can take it. Bring it in here. I want to set it, like, right here. Okay, we can rotate it. Place. There you go. Alright, where'd she go? I guess we have to tell her to sit in it. Hey, you old batshit crazy bitch. I made you a chair. Come use it. There's another one right here. There's 80 chairs in this place. You could have used any of them. But you made me use my hard-earned material. My junk. Where are you going? Get back here! Bitch! Stop it! Go in the chair! I hate this lady. Yeah, right there. Plop your ass down. Don't just stand there and look. Right there! Fuck this.
What kind of help do you need?
Well, for starters, we could use some real beds. We've been sleeping on the ground for too long.
I'd be glad to help.
Okay. Good deal. Just make sure we can sleep with a roof over our heads. Some of these old houses still look solid enough to do the trick. There's a workbench over there you can use. Give me a holler if you need anything.
Yeah. I guess that's something I should be focusing on right now. Build sheltered beds. Wait. It said it was at 100% already. Yeah, I've been trying to figure out the power thing, and then I looked at the laser tripwire thing again, and I found out I don't even have the perk level required to do that yet. I think that's what actually supplies the power to those things, but I think I'm like getting like really far ahead of myself. I think I should be focusing on like food and shelter and beds for right now. Which reminds me, we should have food going out here, right?
Seems to be growing well.
Yeah. So we harvest all this shit. And then we replant it, right? Or I just keep it for myself. Codsworth, buddy! Long time no see. How you been?
Hey, Codsworth.
Sir, welcome back, sir. I do hope you were able to find some assistance in Concord.
Man, a lot has happened since then.
How were things here while I was gone?
Oh, just catching up on old yard work. Some occasional pest control. And you, sir? Anything to be found in Concord?
Yeah.
You could say that. I made a few new friends.
Can't have enough of those these days. I realize that I'm no Mr. Gutsy, but if needed, I'd be honored to accompany you throughout the Commonwealth. Just say the word.
That's badass. What do you have on you, by the way?
I'd like to trade some
items. Of course.
Ah, you have nothing. I could store things in you, but I don't really need to do that. That's so cool! So Codsworth can be a companion. I remember he fucked up those bloatflies, man. That was awesome. Hey, what's up, Preston?
Hey, you ask me. Freedom's always worth fighting for.
Yeah, sure. Alright, so we've got plenty of houses here already. Let's see. Let's look at the quests. Sanctuary. Talk to Sturges. Build sheltered beds. So that was the first one, but we've already completed that. So let's talk to him again and see what else he needs from us. I wonder if we'll actually get some tutorial shit on how to like farm and things like that. Because that would have been really useful like 20 hours ago. But I'll take it when I can get it.
Help out or get lost.
Fuck off, Marcy. I hate you so much. Where did Sturges go? I remember I assigned him to some kind of security station like over this way. And apparently these are all facing the wrong way, so I should guess I should go ahead and turn them around. Let's see if I select it, swivel it around, there we go. I still don't know like how much these things actually help out in practicality, but there they are. They look cool at least. Sturges is not manning them, though. That's slack ass. I don't know what he's doing. I wish I knew, like, where to find him. So can I plant stuff in these types of areas? Dog bowl. Hey, there's a doghouse here. I wonder if that's where dog meat sleeps. I haven't seen him running around. I don't know what the hell happened to him. And now it is raining. So we should probably build something here. Structures. Wood, metal. I mean, we want to build metal if we've got it. So we can build small metal shacks and large metal shacks. I mean, are these like the main structures? Like, what else can we do? Floor and roof, corners. You can put up just straight up walls. Does this let you build like your own? Could you like do them from scratch? Give everything like walls and doorways and kind of make your own structure? That's kind of neat. Takes 10 steel just to build a small wall though. So if we tried to like fit it to the corner here, it's red, it won't even let me drop it there. Well, that's useless. I mean, I'm sure it's not useless. I'm sure that there's some use for it. But, I don't know. It's real obscure. I wish I knew where Sturges went, because apparently I'm supposed to talk to him. But he is nowhere to be found. Alright, well, let's go into these houses and build some more beds, I guess. Fuck. Ooh, there's 10 steel. Was this my house? Yeah, this is my... What is that? Mag, you're special. Whoa, did I ever... Hold on. Oh my god. Pick the attribute to improve. This is awesome. Charisma. Did I just get a point? Just for fucking picking that up? What else is in here?
Certainly seen better days, hasn't it?
I'm coming, buddy.
Oh, I'm still so sad. Guys, that's awesome. I'm pretty sure I just got a point just for picking up that book. Christmas at 5 now. It's pretty good. While I'm in here, let's go ahead and sleep. Let's sleep it off. I've been out in the wasteland for a long time. I'm just gonna sleep overnight. And I'm fully healed. I'm feeling a lot better. It's the start of a brand new day. Not quite light yet, but what are you gonna do? Sturges, there you are, buddy.
I like it. Having a place to sleep will improve everyone's spirits. What we need now is a reliable source of clean water.
I mean, I did put in some taps. Yeah, see, that's done.
I'm on it. Clean water coming up.
Great. Thanks again.
Awesome. What's next?
Hey, Sturges.
I feel better already, knowing we have a reliable supply of clean water. I hope you don't mind me asking for some more help, but our food supplies are running low. If we're gonna settle here, we'll need to get some crops established.
Okay, good. What kind of crops are you looking for?
What kind of crops are you looking for?
It doesn't much matter. Potatoes, mute fruit, corn, whatever you can get to grow.
Okay. I haven't had much luck figuring out that whole aspect. I know that they grow over here, but what I don't know is, like, how you actually plant this stuff and get it going on your own. Does it have to be these little fenced in areas? Didn't we find like little patches of dirt before that we like planted stuff in?
There's a story here. We'll find it.
Let's go ahead and swivel that around. There we go. Maybe we have to be in the workshop mode. Resources, water, food. What's under miscellaneous? Just out of curiosity. Bells, sirens, fast travel targets. Alright. Right, so we've got some corn that we can plant. It can only be placed in dirt. Is this place full up already? Why is it so high? I'm trying to plant it in the dirt, but it's like floating way up high in the sky. If I plant crops near where dog meat lives, is he gonna eat them? I'm trying to lower this thing. And I can't really do it. I can swivel it left and right, but I can't move it up and down. Wait a second. What the fuck, man? Okay, so... this is being very, 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 very finicky about where I can and cannot place this shit. I don't know if it's another case of me doing something, like, really, really wrong. Or if, like, one of the mods I put in just kind of broke this aspect. I really have no idea. That was me picking up a melon patch that was already there. And then trying to put it back down. And it had to be in, like, just the right spot. Like, basically the exact angle and everything that I picked it up from. I couldn't place it anywhere else. And I also tried with one of these damn water pumps that I already put down a bunch of them. And, doesn't really want to go down anywhere either. And I think it's because it's floating too high in the sky. I even tried switching to my mouse controls, and, I couldn't bring it down with that either. So, I don't know what the fuck's going on. I think what I'm actually going to do is just, close this, for now. And just, like, relaunch the game later and try again. Hopefully if I just kind of restart, it'll, you know, reset everything, go back to default, and let me plant this stuff. Because I'm pretty sure this is what I'm supposed to be doing right now. Oh, damn it, I did it again. So, I accidentally picked up the melon patch. And you can see, you can only set it down at, like, a very specific angle here. It's super finicky. And I want to plant the fucking corn there so that we have more stuff. But it's just, like, not going for it. It keeps floating in the sky and I can't bring it down. So, that's some Fallout 4 open world jank right there. That's the only thing I can say about that. I have some editing to do on this video, guys. We didn't make as much progress as I wanted to in Sanctuary, because everything's just so vague and kind of hard to figure out on your own, but we're getting there. I'm making progress. So, we'll dick around with this a little bit more in the next video, guys, and probably, hopefully at some point, move out and go do some Brotherhood stuff, because that's what I really want to get into more than anything, after we get Sanctuary up to snuff and everybody's happy and all that good stuff. So thanks for watching, guys. I'm Dude Long Couch. We'll catch you guys in the next part. Hopefully we have more luck than we did in this one. See ya.